Mr. Srinivasan, I just wanted to ask, when you started off, was brand building something that was inherent to the strategy of Chennai Super Kings, as the name was envisaging? Did you see it getting to $1 billion valuation, or is it something that has just happened along the way? But there is obviously some collective thought that has gone into building this brand with a star power, and we will come to that star power because I mean that is the crux of CSK, to the ethos of it. But I want to understand the strategy, the back room of going from 90 million to $1 billion.
Immediately after the auction was over, I had about 130, 140 investors, analysts on the call telling me that I have done a wrong thing. But I still remember one sentence that I said at that time. I said the market cap of Chennai Super King will exceed that of India Cement one day.
And here
That
we are.
is what I said at that time. I was asked also, then why don't you keep it? Why do you give it? I said, I want every shareholder of India Cement to benefit, which is also what both have come true. But we did not see, it is like the value of the only house that you have, you will not sell it. So
True.
where we are concerned, we will not part with the Chennai Super King. We are in it for the sport. We are in it for the we, I You ask me, what do you want? I want to win more titles. And now that the more teams are coming in, the whole CSK team is a family. We've had consistency from the beginning. We have not changed one support staff from who started with us 12, 13 years. We're still almost the same team. People called us an old man, but there's a lot of experience in the team.
Mr. Srinivasan, you talked about creating a lot of shareholder value by including the India Cements shareholders into this bonanza with you and taking them around the line. You also have very marquee names in the CSK shareholding, LIC, Radhakrishnan Damani as well. Is there any talk of more shareholders coming in? I know you said you will not sell CSK as a franchise, but to get more people on the board, and how do they play into the CSK family, or they're just
No,
merely shareholders?
we have not done anything special. People see value in India Cement, fine. And respectable shareholders are welcome. But we have not done anything special in this regard.
Would
Okay.
you consider listing the company, sir? Would you consider listing CSK at any point?
That is a question to be decided by the board of CSK.
But is that something that would be sort of a dream come true for having a sporting franchise with that kind of a brand value? I mean, it's startup street now. I mean, you look at all these loss-making IPOs also coming in.
I cannot answer this question on air.
Sure. I understand, sir. I completely understand that.
He's 40, and you said he's the king, and the king will stay forever, but the king's playing days are also limited. And he's been asked this question many times: have you considered your future? Have you thought about your future? So is there any conversation about, whether next year in April will we see MS again in CSK, and also in what role?
I know the answer, but I don't know whether I should say it. But it's a happy answer. Don't worry.
It's safe to assume that it's going to be number seven behind his back yet again, and he'll be walking out for the toss.
Left to me, that is what I want. You see, MS is CSK. This may be the one interview I give where I talk about CSK so much. But now the what MS, he's a very fair person. He wanted the retention policy to come out because he did not want to be paid to, he did not want CSK to lose money trying to retain him. He is a very that was the reason why he gave different replies to people. But he made one very pregnant statement when he was asked, what is the legacy? He said, I'm not gone.